Okay, we can field some questions. So you got Sergeant Major McDwyer back here. You got Jeff Colliman right there, and I'm Sergeant Major Lindsey. So any questions out there that we can possibly answer right now, we're all ears. I know we got some questions out there. Everybody can't be totally excited about this. Based off the, okay, that question was, are they going to be able to see the full professional development model? Well, we're working with a lot of the proponents out there right now, and basically that feedback that we receive from those proponents, that is what that's what you'll see as far as the soldier goes. So we need those proponents, the schools, NCOs out there, or sergeant majors out there, basically give us good feedback, and that's also in order to update that thing and keep it relevant to the changing times and things like that. So what you got, Jeff?
Professional development model. Okay, they are in fact the output of the professional development model. For most cases, they're one and the same.
Question.
So, Sergeant Major, two questions. First one. So, is the first line leader, so at the squad leader, platoon sergeant, and then eventually the first line level, are they gonna have the ability to manipulate the soldiers? So, as we move people from organization, that the actual leader has the capability to see his soldiers. And this soldier is going to go to this organization. The second question goes back to the digital job book is eventually going to replace a lot of the paper things that we do. So from that perspective, when data is entered, goes back to your comment before, Sergeant Major, with do we need to have a verification? Is it tied to the individual person who's entering the data? So if I'm entering the data and I'm verifying that my soldier completed this criteria, this training, then when I say he passed, it's tied to my CAC card, tied to me as the first line leader, or it's the platoon sergeant that enters in, it's tied to him. And it says, who verified the training? That individual verified a training and he did it on this date.
Roger, I can take this one, Sergeant Major. So when the alert goes to the company training room NCO from AKO, it shows up and says, hey, this AKO username, so you know, first name dot last name, is submitting these training records to be recorded. Do you agree? You then hit a details button, shows you the details of the APFT, the outcome of the APFT, and then when that trainer NCO records it, we also capture that within DTMS as well. So if you need to do an investigation, you can do that.
Right, there is a level of QAQC. We've struggled with it because my developers want to put all these safeguards. I kind of want to take most of the safeguards off because I want to give you a product, and then that's up to the chain of command how that gets verified. And then if somebody's doing something that shouldn't be done, putting in bogus information or whatever, that's for that chain of command. I'm not here, and I don't want the app to play gotcha for them. Your first question on can I move them around? Yes. So the basis for this, so most of you sergeant majors, if you go look on yours right now, you won't probably not have a leaders tab because you're not listed on anybody's roster that usually is made at the company or battalion level. So the first step to all this is, of course, rosters that we make. So within DTMS, as you make a roster of Alpha Company, First Platoon, and then down to First Squad, and as you assign people to that, you will assign who is the leader for that. And those are the people that have the permissions to get the leader's dashboard and then do the updates. And then so if a soldier moves from one platoon to another company, then his record will move with him and then his new leader will have access to that. Okay. Yes.
What are the PII implications, or if there's any PII implications by downloading soldiers' data into your own personal devices? And the second is, what is the timeline for the app to be developed?
So there is no PII implication per se. What we are using, if you have to access a specific bucket of information in the Army Career Tracker, you will use that, your DS login, username and password. But all your, those bucket information will have unclassified information, is just information content, you know, but the actual, there is no login into the apps, okay? You will be challenged to use your DS logon when you access information back in the .mil domain, but that information will be server-based. So no PII in the app at all.
Hi, my question's reference DTMS. The question is, will DTMS eventually get a chance to interact with email poll, specifically in reference to APFTs and stuff like that? We track that in our PRR, personal readiness reports, and a lot of times there's a kind of a mismatch in information because soldiers are putting it into DTMS, but then you got to turn around and take the same stack of APFT scores and put them into email poll, so you're saturating two people.
Yes, there is a plan in place right now. They do not talk to each other. DTMS does not push to EMILPO, but that is being worked, and I believe it's the first or second quarter of 17. It is in the scope of work for the developers so that you only have to do it once because the database of record for APFT is DTMS. It's not EMILPO. And then once we get that linkage, once you put it in there, it'll do your EMILPO, and then that'll update for the boards and everything else. Any other questions?
Is there any timeline for the app development?
You said it's
October 17th. The app development? So, October 17th. Schedule, we are projecting first quarter FY18, October 17, first quarter FY18. Soon we will task all the proponents to start building the information to populate the app, and we are all well on our way to actually FOC first quarter FY18.
Any other questions? Hey, one key takeaway from what Jeff just said is the proponents out there providing good information for career maps, good information for things that you want associated with the digital rucksack. So that's the important piece of that, is good information in and then good information out. Any other questions? All right, thank you.